You, well, now we're in trouble. I thought as the Range Rover Sport slid backwards down a sand dune, inconveniently littered with pine trees. It looked like the kind folks at Land Rover had made a terrible mistake sending me out to the dunes of Sand Lake, Oregon. You, even their thoughtful inclusion of a hardened off-road driving instructor was not enough to get us out of the predicament. This expert's best efforts to unbeach the car from where I had gotten it stuck were of no avail. We stepped out of the vehicle to find the Sport buried to its skid plates in sand, perilously close to sliding its flawless paint into a tree. I thought that I had finally found something this heretofore impeccable vehicle cool DNT do. You, I want to leave you in suspense. XA0WEDIDNT die of starvation in the sand. And we weren't eaten by marauding ATV riders. In fact, some stopped to help. That is because, despite the grim situation, I was very wrong about the Range Rover Sport. It you do anything. You, it took some digging and airing down of the conspicuously out-of-place street performance tires. But in a surprisingly short amount of time, the Sport and its insane 510-horsepower power plant were soon howling up the 30-degree slope with a vengeance. This experience was simply a repeat of my entire week with the Range Rover Sport. Every time I thought I had finally showed it up, it struck back. You, the supercharged VA lurking beneath the Range Rover's hood howls like a T-Rex on meth. You, the 5.0-liter supercharged V8 lurking beneath a Range Rover's hood howls like a T-Rex on meth, slapping down the throttle out on the sand creates a choking torrent of noise so loud that the world seems to be cut.